So today we'll be talking about our light sensor portfolio under our new product update. So firstly, we have this slide here to show and to bring out the value that TI has and why you would choose us as your light sensor source. One of the first parts of this equation is our expertise. And with over 25 years of experience, this is through writing technical documents or sharing our knowledge through webinars and videos. We have design resources, not only here in America, but also ar around the world. So this expertise, coupled with our supply and being able to ship millions and millions of units per year, and having a great growth rate of over with our licensor portfolio, even during this type of situation that we're experiencing now, we're able to supply and also supply great quality devices and the reliable devices that work the way that they're intended to work. So all these things coupled with the innovation being able to have a very unique place in the market, you can get the desired results like any other that you can experience in this on the market right now compared to any competitor that's out there. So with this, I kind of want to show some background of what we've been doing so far with our ambient light sensor portfolio. So as I said before, back in 1994, we did have our TI's first integrated photodiode amplifier. And through the years, we've made very big strides as to what we currently have in our portfolio. With our first ambient light sensor with photopic response, we also have the world's thinnest ambient light sensor, which was a new package development for us as well. And then we also have gotten to the space of automotive qualification. And we have a very distinct value add in this end that I will go into a little bit more later. And also, even now, we actually have some current investments to move forward in the coming years as well, with not only blue light
blue light.
sensing, but also with a whole new portfolio, which will be called our 4000 family, which will have some higher resolution and much faster speed, and also allow us for multiple channel color sensing, which is multispectral response. And then we also have a new innovative packaging that's coming out as well. But there are a lot of exciting things coming that we've done in the past, and we are definitely moving forward in our future with big investments on that end. So to kind of level set what's happening here at TI and what where licenses are used, we do see them in some typical applications of multiple sectors. One of the first ones being on the portable electronic side. So this includes tablets, speakers, smartphones, things of that nature, laptops as well. And we also get into the industrial side within building automation, lighting control, and with wearables with the very small size, we see this being a very key sector for us as well. And like I stated before, in automotive, where we have a very distinct advantage and value add for the market. And kind of a lot of the key differentiators between these markets, right, that we do have here in TI is a very, very low power consumption and a very great spectral response matching, which is the human eye spectral response matching. So kind of couple that with the use cases for light sensors, we typically see four different use cases. The first being this backlight, display backlight control, which may be the most prominent use case. And this is used across all the sectors, but we like to say whenever you see a screen, there should be an ambient light sensor, and we have that sensor for you. Also, on the daylight harvesting side, which is more of an industrial type of application, we do see the use case for that to be able to change the brightness intensity to reflect really what's going on in the environment and to create a better user experience or a person experience, whatever environment you're in. On the surveillance side, we kind of see this as more of an on-off type of use case, where if it's daylight or nighttime, you need to be able to turn on whether they're infrared LEDs or whatever you may need to do, depending on how much light is in the environment. And we actually specifically put out the wearable side because there are some definitely key things on the wearable side, mainly cost to the small size that they need and the low power consumption, that we do have a specific type of portfolio set for just this type of application. And I'll speak on that in this coming slide. Like I said, you can group our light sensor portfolio into kind of four different buckets. The first one on the top left here shows our automotive side. So we do have the OPT 3001 Q1, and this is we have this device in two form. So we have the grade two version and the grade three version. The grade two version, we are just one of two light sensors that are able to do this grade two version, which goes up to 105 degrees Celsius. This is something that if it's needed, then we do have it there, and which is something unique for our portfolio. On the top right corner of this slide, you see the OPT-3001 and OPT-3004. And these are our two hero products that we see most often used. It has the great human eye response. And the difference between the 3001 and 3004 is that the OPT-3004 has this improved IR rejection. So any new products that we see now, we like to show people the OPT-3004, as it is our new flagship part that has been most recently released. In the bottom left corner of the slide, we see the OPT-3002. This is our one device that has the wide spectrum response. So this includes the wavelengths from 300 nanometers to 1,000 nanometers, which will get you some IR light in, some UV light, and also the human eye spectrum wavelengths in there as well. So this is very good for a lot of tamper detection applications, as well as other applications that require a wide spectrum response. And last but not least, we have the OPT-3007, which is the world's thinnest ambient light sensor. As you can see here, the thickness is just 0.226 millimeters, which is extremely thin. And this is most often used in very size-restrictive applications, like wearables, smartphones, other PE applications as well. But throughout our portfolio, as you can see down the middle, we have common features and specs that you'll see throughout the entire portfolio, which are better explained on this slide. So this slide shows the big value proposition that we do have for our ambient light sensor portfolio. Our novel architecture definitely brings this consistent linearity across and temperature performance across the entire range. And this range being this 23-bit dynamic range from 10 millilux to 83 kLux. So there's a wide range that we do have, and we have the great performance across the entire range. Our spectral matching performance, we have this special filter for 99% human eye spectral matching performance. And this is especially key in a lot of applications where you want to make sure that the device only sees what the human eye does see. So you don't get any false reads for IR light or UV light that the human eye doesn't naturally see. And this coupled with our great resolution for 10 millilux gives us this great performance under dark glass. So this is done for aesthetic reasons most often to hide the ambient light sensor behind some type of glass cover. So you don't see the sensor, but still get that great performance on the human eye spectral matching as well. We do have this unique feature, this automatic gain feature, which is something that we're very proud of. And this automatically adjusts the range setting to ensure the best resolution is given for any lighting condition. So this does not need to be done outside the sensor on the host. This is done internally with our sensor as well. And our power consumption is industry's lowest power, active power, of less than 2 microamps. This is about 7 times lower power than what we see on the market. And one of the things that we're very proud of that we can provide is driver support. So with numerous drivers to support the communication through the I2C bus and registers, which includes Linux, Intel, and much more. And we're continually adding new drivers to our portfolio every day. So here to kind of point out really what we're saying as our competitive highlights, and we have listed here where you will see our portfolio here with, due to power consumption. And you can see based on the competition that's out there, we're at least 7 times lower power. And if you look closely at this graph, this is a logarithmic graph as well. So really the distance between where we are and some of the competitors is a very big gap. And this also coupled with our human eye spectrum response. You can see here that the thick green wave is the human eye spectrum, and this thick red one is where we see our OPT-3000 portfolio. And this is about a 99% match that we see. And you can see kind of where the competition lies on this matching spectrum as well. And this way we kind of see that TI has the best match to the human eye spectrum, which ensures those great results and no false reads for any external light outside of the human visible spectrum. So along with this, there's a couple different package options that we're really excited about. The most common one as of now is this OQFN package option. It has a very simple assembly with the sensor and pads on opposite sides, a very small size as well, about 2 millimeters squared with a 6-pin operation. This is very useful in all market segments, which include automotive, industrial, and also some personal electronics. And this is the most common packaging that we do see on the market compared to other competitors. The WCSP package option, the wafer chip scale package option that you see in the middle, is a very unique assembly. With the sensor and pads on the same side, you'll need to drill a hole through the PCB in order to let the light through. And this way, we can get this very thin, and this is the world's thinnest ambient light sensor package option, as you can see here with the 0.226 millimeters. This is, we do have both a 6-pin and a 4-pin operation, and this is very useful in those size-restricted applications. So the smart watches, the laptop, the phone, things of that nature. And this new package option you see on the right is our SOT packaging option. This is one that we'll be releasing very soon. And this is another simple assembly. It's very similar to the OQFN package option where the sensor and pads are on opposite sides. We will get a little smaller area as far as the sensor packaging size with more flexibility with our pin operation. And this will be useful in all markets as well. So this is something that we're very excited about moving forward with our new products that we will be releasing in the coming future. In a little more detail on this world's thinnest ambient light sensor, so what we have here is this trademark PicoStar packaging option. And as you can see in the picture here, that this is a very, very small package option. And that's the tip of a pencil if you weren't able to see that clearly. So this small size definitely enables to be put into the thinnest of bezels for any application, integrated seamlessly with a flex PCB with a hole over the active area allows for this use, and you can be put behind the display as well. So we see this as a preferred method to put the ambient light sensor integrated behind the OLED display, and we have had multiple people be able to do this for millions and millions of units. And our pin position is optimal for the device to create easy hole alignment and integration into the application. So this is something that we have seen many users use and be very fond of this great new package option that we do call PicoStar. And another thing that I would like to mention is that we also are supplying a lot of videos and other content online to kind of bring you along with light sensors. Whether you're starting off with the fundamentals of light sensing, like in chapter one, and moving all the way to how to integrate our light sensors into your design. So we are producing more and more videos, and they will be released throughout the years, all throughout 2020 as well, to kind of show you the steps from the beginning all the way to the end of your light sensor design. And this is available online currently right now. So without going into a lot of details on this, we do have more information on each device that we do have in our portfolio. Our OPT3002, as we stated before, is this wide spectrum, as you can see in the graph in the bottom right, from 300 to about 1,000 nanometers. It does have the same type tolerance as the rest of our portfolio with a great low power of 1.8 microamps. This is a typical operating current, and the operating temperature from the industrial temperature of negative 40 to 85 degrees Celsius. Likewise, with our OPT3001, just with the human eye response instead of the wide spectrum response, you do get that great IR rejection that we see here from the 10 millilux all the way to 83K lux, and this automatic ring setting that is unique to us. And with the difference between the OPT3001 and 3004, you do get this increased IR rejection over this plus or minus 85 degrees angle of incidence. So this is over, this is the angular IR rejection that we did improve over our OPT3001, which is most times useful in a lot of these applications where you're spewing IR light into the environment. This includes security applications such as IP network cameras and things of that nature. But also this great performance can be used in other sectors, in not only industrial side, but also on the personal electronic side as well. Our OPT3001 Q1, as stated before, we have both the grade 2 and grade 3 version of this for all of our automotive applications. And it still does come with the same type of human eye spectrum matching as the 3001 and that great power consumption that you do see here as well. And kind of last but not least, we have the OPT3006 or 7, which is our world's thinnest ambient light sensor. 3006 is a 6-pin operation, while the OPT3007 is a 4-pin operation, which lets you get a little more area to punch a wider hole so you can get more light to the sensor area for the 3007. And in this case, We often see it used in personal electronics or very size-restricted applications, but we have seen customers implement this in all types of markets, especially if you need that very small size. So we'd like to wrap this up with saying if you need any more information on our products, you can visit www.ti.com/npu for more information on the update, and also online you'll see more information about our licensor portfolio.
Thank you so much. We did not receive any questions on the chat, but since we have some time, happy to open it up if somebody would like to discuss or have a question. Okay, well, thank you guys so much for your time. As a reminder, we will be hosting this on www.ti.com/npu, and we hope you have a great rest of your day.
Thanks everyone for joining.
Thank you.
Thank you.